Hey everyone, my name is Brian. After many years of building with Angular, I'm here to help you level up your skills and build better apps. Have you ever built something like a drop-down menu, clicked to open it, and then realized you forgot to make it close? Yeah, me too. You click outside, nothing happens. You click harder, like somehow that'll help, still nothing. Well, in this video, we're going to fix that by building a modern clickOutside directive. I'll walk you through the whole thing step by step, including a surprisingly common bug that causes the dropdown to close immediately after opening, and how to fix it. Stick around. By the end of this video, you'll have a reusable, production-ready solution that you can drop into any Angular project. Let's get started. First, let's take a look at the app. This is a simple dashboard. It has a top nav, a sidebar, and in the top right corner, we've got a user menu. When I click this avatar button, it opens a dropdown with a few links. So far, so good. But there's one big problem. There's no way to close it. Let's open the user dropdown component template to better understand how this all works currently. Okay, here's the button that opens the menu. It just sets a signal called isOpen to true when clicked. And here's the menu itself. It's wrapped in a condition based on this isOpen signal, so it only renders when it's true. But we don't have anything set up to switch that signal back to false. So how should we fix this? Probably the best way to do this is to add a full page invisible element behind the menu, a shield. And when you click it, we close the menu. Let's try it. I'll drop in a simple button here. And we're just gonna test this out to see if it'll actually work. So I'll add some inline styles. I'll add a background color and a fixed position to attach to the viewport. This will just allow us to vet that this idea will work. Okay, let's save and see how this works. Now, when we open the menu, bummer. The shield is here, but it only covers the header, not the entire page. This happens because of how certain styles are set up. I think, in this case, it's a CSS filter with a drop shadow that is preventing this from applying like we want it to. And this is often the challenge with pop-ups in a framework like Angular. When it's in a component, that component can be used anywhere, and we don't always know or have the ability to change the styles on the parent components that affect it. This approach works sometimes, but in this layout, it fails. We're going to build something better. We're going to build a directive that monitors elements for clicks outside. First, let's remove the shield button since it didn't work. Now, I've already stubbed out this clickOutside directive, so let's open it up. So right now, it's just an empty directive with a clickOutside attribute as the selector. We'll start by adding an output with the same name, clickOutside. This will be emitted when the user clicks outside. Okay, now we need to access the host element that this directive gets applied to in order to later determine if the click occurred inside or outside of the element. So let's inject element ref. Now, to listen to a document click event in Angular, we'll use the renderer2 class, so we'll need to inject it as well. For this concept, we will be using the listen method from the renderer2. This method returns a function that, when called, removes the event listener to avoid performance issues and memory leaks. So let's add another property for this named listener. Okay, now let's add a constructor. Next, we'll use this listener property to store the event listener, and we'll use the renderer property to call the listen method. The first parameter we need to add is the node we want to listen to events on. In this case, it'll be the document. The second parameter is the event. In this case, we want to listen for click events on the document. Now we can add the callback to call when the event fires. In this callback, we'll have access to the event that fired too. So At this point, what we have is a function that will be called anytime there is a click that happens anywhere in the document. What we need to do now is determine if that click occurred inside of our host element or outside. If it occurred outside, we can emit our clickOutside event. If not, we don't need to do anything. So let's add a condition to make sure that the host element does not contain the element from the event target. In case it's not super clear here, the event target is the element that the click event was triggered on. This could be any element in the entire document. Then, within this condition, we just need to emit our event. That's it. Now, when using event listeners, it's really crucial to clean them up when they're no longer needed to prevent performance issues. So we need to be sure to remove this listener when the directive is destroyed. To do this, let's implement the onDestroy interface. Then let's add the onDestroy method. And then we can just call the listener function. Now, the listener will be removed when this directive is removed. So that's pretty much everything we should need here. Let's switch to the user dropdown component TypeScript file. Before we can use the clickOutside directive, we need to import it. Okay, now we can switch to the template and use this directive. Let's add it to the div that contains our dropdown. In this case, since the output and the directive selector are named the same, we can combine them with the event binding syntax. Then, when the clickOutside event fires, we just need to flip the value of the isOpen signal. Okay, I think that should be everything, so let's save and try this out. Now, when I click to open the menu, nothing happens. That's weird. Let's pop this open in a new window so that we can inspect and see what's happening. Let's inspect this. Okay, when we click the button, yep, you can actually see the menu does open, but it closes instantly. Here's what's happening. The click event that opens the menu also bubbles up to the document, and our clickOutside directive sees that click after the menu is rendered. So it thinks you just clicked outside and immediately closes it again. We need to prevent the directive from responding to the very first click that triggered the menu to open. Let's head back to the directive. First, let's add an isFirstClick Boolean property and set it to true. This will be used to track whether it's the first click event or not. Now, within our listener callback, let's add a condition based on this property. If it's true, we'll set it to false, and we'll also just return to avoid emitting the click event. So this should now skip the first document click event that happens right after the menu appears. Now save and try it again. Okay, when I click the avatar, the dropdown opens. And when I click anywhere else, the dropdown closes. Perfect. This works. But there's one sneaky edge case. Let's say we have an element somewhere on the page that uses stopPropagation. For example, maybe a sidebar item needs to prevent bubbling for some reason. Let's open the main component template and find the first link in the sidebar. Let's add a click event here and then stopPropagation on the event. Okay. Now let's save. Now let's open the menu and click that link. The menu doesn't close. Why? Because the document click listener never fires. stopPropagation blocked it. This isn't a bug in our directive. It's just something to be aware of. Our directive depends on the document event firing. If another part of your app cancels that event, it won't work. So this is why I prefer the first example, the shield concept, if possible. It's often a more bulletproof choice when layering modals, dropdowns, or overlays. But sometimes it just won't work, and you need a global clickOutside event. Bottom line, while this directive works great for most use cases, just be aware that If other parts of your app are interfering with event propagation, it might not behave as expected. All right, we built a fully functional clickOutside directive in Angular, walked through the pitfalls, fixed the immediate close bug, and even looked at why stopPropagation can quietly break everything when you least expect it. You now have two solid patterns in your toolkit: a shield element which works reliably for overlays and modals, and a directive that's clean and reusable when that shield concept doesn't work. If this helped you out, do me a favor. Give it a like, share it with someone who's probably fighting this exact bug right now, and subscribe if you want to see more tutorials like this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.